What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your brother, your friend, Apostle Makhario, coming to you all again. There was a question posed by a subscriber, a young man. He asked me if I could do a video on why Adam and Eve ate the bad fruit. He put apple, but it was a fruit. We really don't know what it was, what type of fruit it was necessarily. So here's the response to that, sir. Getting into the scriptures, first I want to take you to Genesis chapter 2, verses 16 and 17. Well, actually 15, 16, 17. This is talking about God speaking to Adam. And it says, "And the Lord God took the man and put him in the midst into the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die." And then the Lord, in verse 18, formed Eve from man's rib. So the first thing I want you to notice, sir, or ma'am, is that God commanded Adam not to eat of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Now, this is going to answer your question why they ate of that fruit. Moving on to Genesis chapter 3. Well, the first thing I want you to notice, actually, if you go back to chapter 2, verses 15 through 17, the first thing that he said in verse 17, actually, "But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die." So the first thing is that when God formed Adam and Eve, they knew they had no knowledge of evil, because everything that God created and everything about God is good. So if you take that into account, that they didn't know about evil, they had no idea that Satan was in the midst of the garden, they had no idea that the animal that was speaking to them was possessed with a spirit, okay, which was Satan. They did not understand that they could be deceived, because they had no knowledge of, they had knowledge of good, but no evil, no knowledge of evil. If you move on to Genesis chapter 3, Satan is a deceiver. We know that. The Bible talks about that all throughout the Bible. The Bible also declares that Satan is a thief. Jesus said in John 10:10, "The thief cometh not but for to kill and to steal and to destroy. But I am come that you may have life and that you may have it more abundantly." So the fact that they had no knowledge of evil made it easier for them to be deceived. If you move on to Genesis chapter 3, and you go into starting at verse 1, "Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, yea, hath God said," so first of all, he's posing doubt. He's putting doubt in their minds. They knew nothing about doubt, because everything that God told them was truth. "Yea, hath God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die." Which was the truth. God only told them truth. That's why I said they only had knowledge of good. In verse 4, "And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die." So now he's putting doubt in their mind, deceiving. It says, "For God doth know that in the day that ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil." So once again, even Satan himself said, right now you all don't know good and evil, but when you eat of the fruit, you'll know good and evil. They only knew good. And then the woman, it says in verse 6, "And the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired, to make one wise. She took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and gave also unto her husband, and he did eat. And the eyes of both of them both were open, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together, and made themselves aprons." The thief cometh not. So to answer your question, young man, and or young woman, whoever may be asking the question, they had no knowledge of evil. They had no knowledge that they could be deceived. They only knew good. But as God said, and as Satan said, you would have knowledge of both good and evil. You will know good and evil. their knowledge of good was so, their hearts were so innocent, their knowledge was so pure that they walked around naked. Have you ever met a child or a young baby, and that young baby constantly takes off their diaper and they just run around naked because they think it's funny or fun? It's just pure innocence, and that's all that they had. So when Jesus said the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy, that's the truth. He stole, first of all, their life from them. Okay, he stole their innocence, which Satan always does. That's why when pedophiles molest young children or whatnot, they're attracted to the innocence that the child has, which is disgusting that they would do that, but it's a plot of Satan. Satan does that on purpose, because if you can steal someone's innocence, you can keep them from hearing the truth and understanding the truth and knowing God easier. But the moment that you return to God through Jesus Christ, you start to restore. That innocence starts to get restored. Your sins are washed away, so you have a clean slate. So Satan stole their innocence. He killed their life. He's a murderer. That's what Jesus said in John 8:44. He's a murderer because he took the life of humanity from the beginning when he had the chance. And he destroyed their perception of who they are and who they were. And when I say he destroyed their perception, you notice right after their eyes were open, after Adam ate, it wasn't when Eve ate, because Adam was the head. So that's something else, just another golden nugget. Adam, so the man is supposed to be the head of the household. So because Adam was the head, that's when their eyes were open. Not when Eve ate the apple, because the Bible says that, or not the apple, the fruit, because the Bible says that she ate first, and then she gave to Adam, and that's when their eyes were open. So pay attention to that as well. But it destroyed their perception, because once they realized that they were naked, the Bible automatically says that they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves aprons to cover their nakedness. And then if you continue on in that story, it talks about how, or that account, it talks about how God asked them, who told you that you were naked? Because all they knew was innocence. They didn't know evil, they only knew good. So to answer your question, why did they pick the fruit and eat it? Simply because they were innocent. They had no idea, no knowledge that they could be deceived. They didn't know that anybody or anything would tell them anything evil or anything that would hurt them, because God only told them the truth. And that's all they knew. The truth, honesty, and innocence. So that, I hope, is the answer to your question. I mean, I can take you to other scriptures to talk about deception and how, you know, we need to keep our hearts pure, and that's what God is trying to do, just bring us back to that place of perfection, because Adam and Eve were perfect before they ate that fruit. And that's what God sent Jesus Christ here to do, to take us back to that place of perfection where we can walk with God. The other thing, before I let you all go, is that the Bible declares, and this is all they had to do, actually, Adam and Eve, even though God had already spoken to them, but all they had to do, and they didn't have the scriptures back then, but they should have just waited and spoken to God again and let God know what was going on. But the scripture says in Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6, and this is where Eve went wrong and Adam allowed himself to go wrong. It says in Proverbs 3, 5 and 6, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. So had Eve and Adam waited to talk to God in the cool of the day when the Bible says that God would come down and talk to them, then they would have known that it was a deception from Satan, and God could have prevented that. But that also ties into how we live our life now. Instead of us rushing into things like most people do, if we would take a moment and ask God, acknowledge God, and say, God, you know what? I'm in a dilemma. This thing looks good, it sounds good, but I don't know if it's good for me. Had they done that, none of this would have happened, because God came down daily and talked with Adam and Eve, for that matter, in the cool of the day. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's something to keep in mind. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Don't lean to your own understanding. And that's the problem that Eve had. She went to her own understanding for what she thought, simply because she was innocent. She didn't know any better. But had she waited, God already told them once. If she would have waited, he would have just confirmed it, and none of this would have happened. So I hope that answers your question. I'm glad when people ask questions, because that helps us all grow in knowledge and revelation and understanding of who God is. So I love you all. I will see you all again soon. May God bless. We are out.